Despite the fact that you can hear maybe a chainsaw in the background, we are in fact in the jungle. Welcome to the first of three videos about how to improve the health of your garden, especially the health of your soil. What we're going to do is we're in our cabin right now in the rainforest, but we're going to be going for some walks this week right into the jungle to learn about how we can learn from the jungle, from nature, to improve the health of our garden. Admittedly, this first video is actually a little more about how our garden differs from the rainforest. But it's still going to be interesting to compare the two. And the first thing I want to talk about is mineralization of your soil, or balancing your soil fertility. All of the three videos I'm going to shoot are of equal importance, but I usually start there because when I go into a new garden or when I'm installing a new garden, I want to often get a soil test done and send it off to a lab. And it takes a couple of weeks sometimes to get the results back. And then I can think about mineralizing the soil, fertilizing the soil. But I want to do that right away so I can, you know, send it off to the lab to get those results. So first, what I'm going to be talking about today is soil fertility. So what can we learn from the forest about fertility? Well, we can learn a lot of things, and some of them are going to come in later videos. But if you think about a forest, nobody fertilizes the forest. There's nobody bringing in calcium or any kind of fertilizer. And that's why a lot of people think, oh, I don't want to fertilize my garden. Nobody fertilizes is a forest or a prairie, and you know, if I just make compost, is very popular in the organic world, then that's going to be sufficient to fertilize my garden. And I kind of understand that, but what I want to talk about today is why our garden is different and why I think you do want to do a little bit of fertilizing in your garden, and I'm going to give you a few tips today on how to do that. The reason the forest doesn't need fertilizing is because something is always going to grow here, unless you have soil that's incredibly toxic or something like that. Even then, there are plants for every situation. And so what happens in a forest or anywhere that's natural is you have, when you hardly have any soil, you have plants that come in. They're called pioneering species. They're often nitrogen fixing plants, but they may be various kinds of plants and microorganisms, lichens. They come in, they sprout up. Of course, this takes decades and centuries. But eventually the right plant for the soil here and for the climate, is that a monkey? is going to come in. And most of the plants that sprout are not going to grow, but that's okay because some will grow and eventually you have this cool forest. So that's really why you don't need fertilizer in a forest. Something is always something that's going to come in. You can do the same thing in your garden if you want to, and I've actually known a couple of people who've done that, which is just to let the weeds grow up. And we call them weeds, but they're really just plants. And what they're going to do is kind of improve your soil over time. More species of plants will come in. Maybe eventually, after decades or centuries, it becomes a forest like this, or maybe not. But it will be a garden, kind of. The reason we want to fertilize is because we want to dictate which plants come in. We want to plant them, and we want to make sure they will grow there. And we want them all to live, not just 10% of them. And we want them to thrive. If you leave your garden alone, is it going to produce tomatoes or strawberries or big, beautiful, award-winning roses? For most of us, the answer is no. It's, you know, if most of those plants didn't evolve where we're trying to grow them, they came from often another continent entirely, and most of them aren't perfectly matched for our soil conditions. So it doesn't mean you can't plant them and maybe get some okay plants, but if you want really healthy plants, then that's when a little bit of fertilizers can help, and you don't need a lot. It's actually amazing just how little you need to tweak the system to make it work for plants like these. The easiest way to know which fertilizers to use is to go and get a soil lab that is very organically minded. Get them to analyze your soil. They'll tell you which macronutrients and micronutrients are lacking or imbalanced in your soil, and then they will tell you what to bring in and how much to bring in. It's really easy to do that way. Now, most gardeners skip this step. Many of them still have fine gardens, but if you're trying to grow really healthy plants that are free of pests, and especially what I'm interested in is food that is really full of nutrients, that's when I think this step is worthwhile, just to get a soil test done, do a little bit of fertilizing. The reason we need a soil test is because we want to add the right nutrients. That's not just NPK, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium. It's not even things like dolomite, lime, which people often add just for good measure. Those can often cause problems. What we want is to know exactly which minerals we need to add in there. And that's why often blended fertilizers that you buy from a garden center or a fertilizer supply place are not right because they may be bringing in some of the nutrients you need, but they may be bringing in some of the nutrients you already have enough of or too much of, and then you're just further shifting things out of balance. That being said, there is one kind of fertilizer you can bring in without a soil test, and that is rock dust, usually from a glacial source or a volcanic source. You can get it from some more of a specialty fertilizer store, or you can go right to a quarry and get it if you're willing to do some testing to make sure it's good and doesn't have any problems with it. But you can bring that in, and what it does is it brings in a broad spectrum of nutrients. So it doesn't bring in a lot of any nutrient, which means it's not going to throw anything out of balance. And that's why you can use it without a soil test. So you can bring it in, it's going to make sure you have just a base of lots of different nutrients, and you're not going to cause any problems. And although it may seem kind of weird to bring in rock dust, a lot of experimentation around the world has shown that it works, even though our soils usually do have at least a little of every nutrient. They really do. Bringing the rock dust in has done a lot of good in gardens and even in forests. Another thing we can do is called foliar fertilizing, which means we're spraying things like ocean water, just straight ocean water from a clean source, or kelp that's been made into a liquid. We spray that onto our plants, and it's especially useful during the early growing stages of plants, or when your soil maybe isn't popping enough to make your garden really grow healthy. Now, paradoxically, you actually need to have a reasonably healthy soil, especially you need enough calcium in order for the plants to be able to take up these nutrients through their leaves. We get all those minerals down into the soil, they get into the plants. The plants then have all the micronutrients to create the enzymes in order to be healthy, in order to maximize photosynthesis and do all of these plant processes. And then the really nice thing for us, if we're growing food, is that we get to eat the plants that have the micronutrients in them. And even if you're already eating a healthy diet, if you're trying to eat organic food, a lot of our organic food, especially the industrialized organic food, is pretty low in nutrition. So that's why I'm really into growing my own food and trying to use these different methods to get fertility both into the soil and directly into the plants so that I get to get that fertility into me later and then I can be healthier. So what I really wanted to share today is more how, as I said, a garden is different than a forest. It's different because we want to control which plants grow. We want them to be very healthy. We want everything we plant to live and thrive and produce nutrient-dense food for us, or at least be, if we're growing ornamentals, have beautiful flowers and be free of pests. And so that's really what I was talking about today. In the next video, I'm going to talk about something different, but it relates very much to fertility and to water, and it's much more about how we can emulate nature in our gardens. For those of you watching who are not in the Smiling Gardener Academy, which is my online, very comprehensive organic gardening course, where I teach soil testing and mineralization and soil fertility and all these things I've been kind of talking about today. If you're interested in that, you might want to check it out this week because the price is actually going to be going up on Monday night.